Hey guys, today I'm going to be talking about package management in Kubernetes using Helm. I'm going to explain essentially what the problem is, why do you need package management in Kubernetes, where does Helm fit in this ecosystem, how to use it to run applications in your Kubernetes clusters, and finally when you should and shouldn't be using Helm. So let's dive right in. Before I begin, I'm assuming you already understand some basic Kubernetes concepts and have at least deployed a simple Hello World application. And if you have, you know that you have to write a bunch of YAML configurations called manifests to create all the components. So imagine you want to deploy a real-world production-ready application like MySQL. You'd be writing manifests for config maps, services, stateful sets, persistent volumes and claims, and tens of other things to bring it all together. And if all that sounds like you're reinventing the wheel, yes, you are. You're not the first one deploying MySQL to Kubernetes, so chances are the community has already written all these manifests and put them in a nice clean package available for download. And that's where Helm comes in. It's a tool to discover and install applications that are built for Kubernetes. Helm packages contain code that solve common problems so you don't have to write complex manifests from scratch. Helm is for Kubernetes what npm is for Node.js, pip is for Python, or apt is for Debian Linux. Now, let's go over some basic terminology in Helm. A chart is essentially a Helm package. It's a collection of files describing some Kubernetes resources to create. A single chart could represent a small component such as an Nginx pod or even a full-fledged stateless microservice with a database, message queue, etc. So you will find MySQL charts or Redis or even Kafka charts out there. To run a chart, you have to install it on your cluster using Helm install. A repository is an HTTP server that stores and serves Helm charts. Your local Helm CLI points to one or more repositories to pull or push charts. A repository might be public, such as Artifact Hub, or private, let's say when you want to store your organization's private charts. When you install a chart on your cluster, Helm creates a new release to track it. So if you want to run three different instances of Redis, say production, staging, and development, you can install the Redis chart thrice with different configurations, and all of them will have different release names to uniquely identify them. The Helm architecture is broadly two components, the client and the library. The client is a CLI tool for end users. This is how you tell Helm what to do. The client manages repositories, downloading and publishing charts, and talks to the Helm library for Kubernetes operations. The library is the backend that receives requests from client CLI, talks to the Kubernetes API, and executes all operations like installing, upgrading, or uninstalling a chart in the cluster. Note that Helm version 2 used to have something called the tiller, but starting with v3, that has been removed for security reasons, so it's no longer relevant to us. You install Helm on your local workstation to use it. It learns about your Kubernetes clusters from your kubeconfig file. It stores all the release information in Kubernetes itself. So even if you uninstall Helm from your laptop, you're not going to lose any state data. And that was all the theory. It's now time to dive into some action. I'm now going to show you how to use Helm to install and run MySQL on Kubernetes. The focus here is going to be using Helm, but if you're also interested in what goes into running a production MySQL database in Kubernetes, you should check out my other video on the same, the link for which is on your screen and in description. So my lab setup includes running Minikube on a Linux virtual machine. I also have kubectl and Helm already installed on this system. Of course, in a real-world setup, you'd have a production-grade Kubernetes cluster running somewhere, and kubectl and Helm would probably be on your local workstation. Here's the MySQL chart that I'm going to use. Bitnami publishes and maintains Helm charts for lots of popular open-source projects. As you can see, a lot of configuration comes packed inside a production-ready chart. So let's try and run MySQL using this chart. First, we must add the repository to Helm. Okay. All right, I have it. Now let me search for a MySQL chart in Bitnami. I see it. Let's install MySQL. Installing a chart will pull it from the repository and apply it to our Kubernetes cluster. This means we can expect MySQL to start running once this command executes. In this command, I specify the release name as production. Perfect. I see the pods running now. I can use the Helm list command to know which releases are being managed by Helm in my cluster. To connect to the database, I'll start a MySQL client container. All right, and let's connect to the primary. Okay, everything seems good, right? But so far I just ran the MySQL cluster as it was given to me. What if I want to run it with some custom configuration? For example, for my staging MySQL, I want to set a custom master password and would only like to give it 5 GB of storage. How do I modify the configurations of a Helm chart based on my needs? This is where we use the concept of values.yaml file in Helm. Helm is also a templating engine where chart developers write their manifests with template variables. The user can then specify the values of these variables in a values.yaml file. Helm will then override the default values in the chart with the values that you supply. Every chart comes with a default values.yaml file that you can check. You can then decide which values to override. Let's see the default values of Bitnami MySQL chart. As you can see, every possible parameter that can be configured is available here for configuration. I can find the root password configuration. I can also find the storage configuration. So I know exactly what needs to be changed. So here's my custom configuration for the staging MySQL. You can see a password and persistent settings. Let's install a new revision now. Notice that I'm specifying the values YAML to the install command now. It seems to have run. Let's check. Okay, it looks like our root password is what we set. I can also see that staging only has 5 GB of storage available, so our custom configuration was applied successfully. Okay, so if I run Helm list now, notice that I'm running the same MySQL chart twice. One release is called production, and the other one is called staging. I'm now going to go ahead and destroy my production database. Pretty sure I'm not the first one to be doing that. And it's been deleted. Helm uninstall removes the resources it created as part of the chart. That's all for this video, folks. We saw the need for package management in Kubernetes, how Helm makes your life a lot easier, and how you can use it to run applications in your clusters. Of course, I only touched the very basics. There's a lot more going on. Helm provides a lot more features like upgrades, rollbacks, publishing your own charts. The list goes on. And while you learned how Helm can help you, it is also very important to know when not to use it. If you just want to run a single container on a single machine, or you have a custom microservice that doesn't really need redistribution, or you plan on writing your own YAML anyway instead of, you know, using community components, Helm is an overkill. This tool only shines at scale, just like Kubernetes. I'm going to leave you with that thought. If you found this video useful, please support me by liking and sharing. And if you're new to my channel, hit the subscribe button, because I release these bite-sized videos every other week to teach you about some interesting problem in engineering and DevOps. Cheers!